question. Does anyone else hate the term soft skills? All I know is what they really should call them are life skills, critical life skills. I wanted to start covering the top life skills that you need to start perfecting like yesterday. Hello everyone, my name is Ellie over here at Forth. If we haven't met yet, I'm so glad that you're here. If you would, hit the subscribe button below and the bell notification so that you don't miss a thing. We drop a new video every Tuesday and we would love to have you in the Forth fam. As mentioned, today we're gonna cover the top life skills that you need to start perfecting right now. The first skill to start perfecting is listening. Okay, Ellie, I'll work on my listening skills, but really. I am such a culprit of not listening. A lot of times we think in a conversation, our role is to communicate well, and to get our point across. However, there is a key missing point here. When we do not listen to what is being said to us, it is incredibly easy to not communicate well. So how do you do this? How do you practice this? Well, the way that I have practiced this in recent years is when I leave a conversation, when I leave a coffee date, when I leave an interview, any sort of communication, and I'm back in my car and I'm driving home, I like to try to think, what did I learn from them? What was my takeaway? What did they say? And kind of do a quick reflection. And I know that if I'm not sure, if I didn't really soak up any information that they may have shared, then I did not do a good job listening. Now, the first couple of times you may be bummed out. You may be thinking, wow, I thought I was a good listener, but obviously not. And so the point of this is to kind of get in that rhythm of leaving conversations, reflecting back and realizing and evaluating yourself if you actually did a good job listening. And then take that feedback, take that self-awareness into the next conversation. If you have to start the conversation mentally thinking, I want to talk as little as possible and only respond to things they're saying to me, then so be it. The more you do that, the more you're gonna get in a habit. Just like with anything, the more you do it, the better you are. Can I also just say that most people don't listen? So even when you can take little incremental progress towards being a better listener, you are going to shine in your workplace, in your friend group, in leadership roles, in your family. People are going to take note of this incredible skill that you've gained, and they're going to want to work with you and want to talk to you because you are someone who's actually taking it seriously. I know I just mentioned listening is a part of communication, but the opposite of listening is speaking, right? Or talking or getting your point across. And so in order to start mastering this skill, just like with anything, you have to get your reps in. One of the biggest questions that I get from students, from job seekers, from career enthusiasts, just like yourself, is they get stumped when it comes time to write an email. You want it to sound good, you want it to sound professional, but you just don't know where to start. You don't know how it's supposed to sound altogether. You don't want to come off young, you don't want to come off inexperienced or rude or unprofessional. But the biggest thing that I want you to remember when you're thinking about communication is, what is in it for them? So why should they listen to you? Why should they open your email? Why should they give you a call back when you leave a voicemail, right? People do most things for selfish intention. That's the way we naturally are, right? We're thinking about us. And so when we're communicating, we want to think about what's in it for them. Why should they pay attention? And also with that goes, what is the point, right? What's the punchline here? What do I really need them to understand? And then you can say what you're trying to say in less words, right? Short and sweet is the name of the game. The next skill that you absolutely need to start mastering and practicing is problem solving. Now, this one gets me every time, because every time I ask someone, are you good at problem solving? Everyone thinks that they're a good problem solver. Newsflash, you might not be. Sometimes we think about problem solving as being an engineer or being innovative or you know, mystery and clues and finding the right answer and solving this big problem. But what I'm talking about is more along the lines of troubleshooting. So what troubleshooting entails is you come across a roadblock, you get to a dead end in the road, and you just freeze. What I need you to do is to jump into action, right? So as an example, you don't know how to get a software to work. You don't know how to respond to an email. A client comes to you with a problem. Even in the job search, maybe someone doesn't show up to your interview. What do you do? You've got to think quick on your feet. Use Google, use the resources at your fingertips, and communicate, communicate, communicate. So many times young people get a bad rap for being entitled or lazy, right? When in reality, we are able as millennials to use resources at our fingertips. We know how to use the internet, right? We know how to use YouTube. And so what I would encourage you to do is make that a strength of yours. Be someone who other people come to help solve a problem or to help troubleshoot. The next soft skill or life skill or people skill that I really think sets people apart is attitude. In work, in business, in life, in love, in family, people do not like spending time with others that don't have a good attitude. They may tolerate it. They may have to be in the same room as you. They may not say anything. But at the end of the day, if they have a choice to keep you on their team, to work with you in the future, they will choose to not work with you if you have a bad attitude over someone who has a good attitude. When I think of attitude, I think about those posters that we saw in middle school that were, you know, plastered up on the hallway, like have a good attitude or think on the bright side, right? And it goes beyond that. What it really is seeing the silver lining and being someone that other people want to be around. I've talked about this before, but people buy you and then they buy anything that goes with you. And so if you are someone who may be negative or just maybe sees things on the negative side, other people aren't going to want to associate themselves with that sort of thinking or with that sort of attitude. And let me just tell you, if you hear nothing else today, this is one of the most important because attitude is going to seep into your problem solving. It's going to seep into your listening, your communication, verbal and written. It's going to come across in everything that you do, and it's going to impact your future career. Okay, friends, that is that in terms of soft skills, life skills, people skills, whatever you want to call them. We talk about mastering listening, communication, problem solving, and attitude. These four soft skills are so crucial to mastering. And what I would just encourage you to do is to pick one. Pick one to reflect on this week. Think about it in your interactions, in your emails, in your everyday conversations, in your job search. Are you doing this well? Is there room for improvement? And then set goals for yourself to get better, to improve, and to really make a point of letting that lead you in your career so that when people think of you, they think of someone who does listen, who communicates well, who problem solves, and who has a good attitude. If you loved this video as much as I loved making it, hit that like button below. We just love having you here in our fourth family, and we would love your family to be a part of it as well. Send it to a friend, send it to a fellow career enthusiast just like yourself. And if this wasn't enough goods for you, we have something special. We're currently building our wait list for our signature method, Get Hired Bootcamp, and we would love to have you as a part officially of the fourth fam. I have linked the wait list below, so please check that out. We've also linked everywhere else that you can find us, our podcast, our Instagram, our website, and we would love to have you follow along. Thanks so much for being here, friends, and go forth.